वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू आवर चैनल anujindal.in. आई एम योर फ्रेंड चेतन. सो गाइस, इन टुडेज सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस, वी आर बेसिकली गोइंग टू एनालाइज द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चंस और व्हाट इज द ट्रेंड ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस बीइंग आस्क्ड इन फेज वन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी 2022. तो हम एक ट्रेंड एनालिसिस करेंगे. वी विल ट्राई टू प्रेडिक्ट दैट वॉट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन, वॉट टाइप ऑफ डिफिकल्टी लेवल विल बी देयर This year in 2022 phase 1 examination. तो quant और reasoning का analysis मैं करूंगा and GA analysis will be done by Neha ma'am. Okay. So without wasting any time, let us begin. First of all, we will discuss about quant and reasoning pattern, their trend of questions being asked and what questions we can expect this year, from which topics, how many questions from which topics and the difficulty level, right? So before that, most of you must be aware, we are offering a crash course of phase 1 and phase 2 complete, and currently it is available at a very very discounted price of ₹11,000. So you can go through the details of this course from our website. Moreover, we have also launched another course for descriptive writing, exclusively for descriptive writing, which is for phase 2. Okay, so this course is available at a discounted price of ₹5,999 if you use the code RBIDW50, right? So in this you will be getting 10 English descriptive tests, 10 ESI and 10 FM descriptive tests, and 5 tests will be assessed and remaining 5 will be evaluated through live sessions by Anuj sir himself. Now let us start discussion on quant and reasoning. First of all, we will discuss about quant. Okay, so basically these are the topics from which you can expect questions in the examination. So it is not that ki questions will be asked from every topic, aisa nahi hota. So every year some topics are skipped by RBI and some topics are being taken up. But if I talk about the overall overall scenario, so basically these are the topics, total number of topics from which questions can be asked in the examination, and the numbers which I have written in the brackets, these indicates the number of questions which were being asked in 2021 attempt. This is not 100% correct, because you know that we do not get the question paper, this is all memory based. तो ये 100% करेक्ट नहीं है, बट आई विल ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन कि क्या हम यहां से डिड्यूस कर सकते हैं, व्हाट कैन बी इन्फर फ्रॉम दिस प्रीवियस ईयर questions, because we are expecting that difficulty level will remain almost the same this year also. So basically some important points which we must consider here is, number one, from data interpretation you can expect 7 to 10 questions from data interpretation. Okay, so generally they will give you 2 DIs, so the DI can have 3, 4 or 5 questions. Ek DI se aapse 3, 4 ya 5 questions pooch sakte hain, and generally they ask 2 DIs in the examination. So in total you have 30 questions in quant and you get 25 minutes to solve them. Okay, so DI 7 to 10 questions. Then sequence series, very very important. So sequence series is a part of DI also, is a part of quant also, and you can also put it under the reasoning part as well. Okay, so in sequence series there are number series, there are alphanumeric series, numeric series, so different types of series are there. So every year some questions, 2 or 3 questions are being asked at least from number series, which makes it very very important. Okay, then another important topic is of inequality. So inequality mein kya hota hai, you are being given 2 equations and you have to check whether x is greater than y, whether y is greater than x, whether x is greater than equal to y. So these types of questions generally come under the category of inequality, and this inequality is itself not a topic. Generally this inequality will ask you questions from the topics of quadratic equation, or it can ask questions from other topics as well, like mixture allegation, ratio proportion. So inequality mein kisi bhi topic ka question aa sakta hai, generally quadratic equation ka question kafi puchte hain. Then number system, very very important. So number system and HCF LCM, they are very very connected to each other, number system and HCF and LCM. So 3-4 questions you can expect from these two combined, number system and HCF and LCM. Then quadratic equation, so this is combined with inequality. Inequality and quadratic equation you can expect 3-4-5 questions from these two. Then ratio, proportion and variation, again very very important. Very very important, you can expect one question from that also, one or two questions. So ratio, proportion and mixture allegation. So these two combined, you can expect 2-3 questions. So it varies every year, aisa nahi hai, fix nahi rehta hai, but still we can get a broad idea, okay. Then time and work, time and distance. These two are also very very important. इनसे भी आप 2-3 questions तो expect कर ही सकते हो. And pipe and cistern and time and work are related to each other. So pipe and system में आपका time and work का ही concept लगता है. And boat and streams and speed and distance are also connected. Okay. So what RBI can do? They can ask questions from boat and streams. Time and distance से नहीं पूछेगी, maybe. Or they will ask questions from trains. Trains का जो topic होता है वो आपका speed distance से ही आता है. Then partnership से you can expect 1 or 2 questions. Generally they ask questions from partnership. Averages and ages, these two are connected to each other. Very very related concepts. Similarly, simple compound interest, percentage, profit and loss. These three are also connected and you can expect 3-4 questions from there as well. And these three topics which I have written in the last, these are not very very important. So you can, maybe you can prepare for them at the last. Once you have completed the other topics, then maybe you can prepare these topics because these are not that much important. So this was all regarding quant. Now let me tell you about reasoning. Ab reasoning ke bare mein bhi thoda sa discuss kar lete hain. So this is the entire gamut of areas from which questions can be asked from logical reasoning. Okay. And in reasoning we are only concerned with verbal reasoning. So the questions are only asked from verbal reasoning. Non-verbal se generally questions nahi aate hain. Okay. So non-verbal means pictorial questions or ग्राफिकल क्वेश्चंस वो नहीं पूछते हैं. सो दीज आर द एंटायर गैमेट ऑफ टॉपिक्स. और इसमें से जो ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है, सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट या फिर मैं बोलूं सबसे ज्यादा वेटेज जिसको दी जाती है वो है पजल्स. ओके. सो पजल से यू कैन इजीली एक्सपेक्ट 20-25 क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम पजल्स. लेकिन जो पजल्स आपका टॉपिक है, सो पजल्स सीटिंग अरेंजमेंट जो है वो भी आपका पजल्स का पार्ट हो जाता है. Order and ranking, this is also considered a part of puzzles. So seating arrangement and order and ranking, these are considered part of puzzles. Okay. So 20-25 questions you can expect from puzzles. Apart from that, input output. So generally this question, it consists of 4-5 questions and this is very very scoring. Generally it is very very scoring. Maybe they can ask a very tricky question, that's a different scenario, but generally you can score 5 out of 5 in input output. Then syllogism and Venn diagram, so 2-3 questions from this topic as well. Aur ye bhi kafi scoring hota hai if you are very very thorough with syllogism, right? Then data sufficiency, isse bhi kafi question aata hai. So data sufficiency can be a part of reasoning also and can be a part of quant also. So data sufficiency mein kya hoga, aapko do statements de denge maybe, और दे विल गिव यू अ स्टेटमेंट एंड एक उस स्टेटमेंट के नीचे आपको दो स्टेटमेंट और दे देंगे. सो यू हैव टू टेल वेदर यू कैन आंसर द क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दीज टू स्टेटमेंट्स और नॉट. ओके. दिस इज डेटा सफिशियंसी. इससे भी 2-3 क्वेश्चन आ जाते हैं. देन अल्फाबेटिकल टेस्ट, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो अल्फाबेटिकल टेस्ट में दे कम अप विद न्यू वेरिएशंस. लाइक दे विल गिव यू कि ये आपके पास एक वर्ड है, इससे आप कितने वर्ड्स फॉर्म कर सकते हो. So let's suppose there is a word called assassination. So how many words can you form from this word assassination? And there are various variations of this alphabetical test. Sequence series, it is also a part of quant and also a part of reasoning. Okay, analogy, classification, coded relation and fictitious symbol. जिसमें आपको बोल देते हैं plus represents that he is the father, minus represents he is the mother, something like that. Connected to your blood relations also. Then coding decoding, okay. Then sequence and symbols, okay. Coding decoding, sequence symbols, these are also very very important. Distance and direction. Now this distance and direction is different from speed, time and distance. Isme kya hota hai, you are being given that a person goes 5 km east, 6 km west, something like that, okay. So the concept of displacement is very very important here. Then cause and effect, statement and argument. To ye jo sare ke sare statement type questions hote hain, these all are statement and assumption type questions. Statement argument, statement assumption, statement conclusion. तो ये थोड़े से subjective questions होते हैं जिसमें generally students lose marks. कई बार हम इसमें marks lose कर जाते हैं. तो इन सब के बीच का difference हमको बहुत अच्छे से पता होना चाहिए. So combined, if you combine all these 6-7, 6-8 questions तो आराम से यहाँ से आ जाते हैं. So this was all regarding reasoning. तो रीजनिंग में आपके 60 क्वेश्चंस हैं, यू विल बी गेटिंग 45 मिनट्स एंड इन क्वांट यू हैव 30 क्वेश्चंस फॉर 25 मिनट्स. सो दिस वाज ऑल आई वांटेड टू डिस्कस अबाउट क्वांट एंड रीजनिंग. नाउ नेहा मैम विल डिस्कस अबाउट जनरल अवेयरनेस पार्ट.
Everyone, so as Chetan sir has described to you the paper pattern of quant and reasoning, I am going to discuss with you the paper pattern of GK. At the same time, we are also going to look into the type of questions that you can expect in your upcoming examination. Okay, so let's begin here, guys. So I hope that you are enjoying the session so far, and believe me that knowing the path makes the journey easy, right? So this is the thing that we are doing for you now. Now guys, you can clearly see I have divided the questions that were there in your examination for the past 3 years into different segments, as you can clearly see. And don't worry, you will be given the PDF of this session as well. So you can keep this PDF in your mind and or alongside your Spotlight magazine and prepare only then. Okay, so now what are the inferences that we can draw from this table? First of all, you can see here clearly that you have 17 questions coming from the government schemes in the last year, 2020 to 2021 paper. And one more thing that I want to clarify here, that thing is that from this year onwards, the paper pattern of RBI has evolved. It has become more and more difficult, right? So in 2018, where you were having questions like the latest member to join BRICS, in 2020 to 2021, you faced questions that were more twisted, more lengthy, more time consuming, right? So there were no straight questions. So here two things we have drawn. First is that paper pattern is becoming difficult. And second thing, that lengthy questions can be expected in your upcoming examination. So prepare in accordance with that. And you need not to worry about the kind of questions, because I provide and make the questions keeping in mind the latest pattern of RBI examination. Because we see a very huge change in this year's examination, right? Whereas in 2018 to 2019, the paper was going smooth, the level was easy to moderate. But in 2020 to 21, in all the sections of phase one, the paper was turned upside down in terms of the level of difficulty. Okay, so first thing is government schemes. Now, what is the source from where you can cover the government schemes? Use the PDF that we provide. Secondly, use the session by Manish sir. And you all must be having the timetable that we have given to you. So there we have conducted one session of 400 questions of government schemes recently. Now there are more sessions of the government schemes coming up in the coming days. So do not forget to attend. Now the next most important section is the national news section. So here you can see that in 2018, you had 6 questions coming from the national news section. Now, what do I mean by the national news section? Now, guys, you can see that I have divided the sections or the questions on the basis of the sections that are there in the Spotlight magazine, so that it will be easier for you to know, to identify which section of the Spotlight is more important for you and where do you have to focus more. Theek hai? So in national news, like India's first conservation center, India's first lichen sparks, these kinds of questions are in the national news. One more thing that I observed in the past years, that is articles. Yes guys, articles of the constitution have also been asked from you in the examination, but does that mean that you have to go through the entire constitution of India? No guys, don't worry about it, because this is not UPSC, right? Pay attention to the articles that are there in the news. That is one point. Next point is that there are the constituencies of politicians being asked in the examination. For example, in this year's examination, or maybe in 2019, Ram Vilas Pasman's constituency was asked. Okay, so in this manner, you need to pay attention to the articles of the constitution. At the same time, you need to pay attention to the politicians' constituency as well. Now there was one more question in this year's examination regarding the Puducherry's state assembly seats, because Puducherry's state assembly was dissolved during that time period and therefore that question came up. So such kind of questions need your attention. Now guys, the next important section is the state, because you can see consistently questions are being asked from the state segment. Okay, 7 questions were there in 2018, 7 in 2019, and 8 questions in 2020 to 2019. Now, what kind of questions are asked in the state segment? First of all, if there is a new appointment of the governor, or if the governor of the state is in the news, so they ask governor. And this question, guys, has been seen in more than one or more than 2 papers. Okay, then you have been asked about the state festivals. Again, whenever I teach you, I always tell you that state festivals are always important. Next, apart from these things, the state symbols. Okay, like in 2018 you had one question on Kuchipudi dance. So which state does the Kuchipudi dance form belong to? This was, guys, the question. So this shows you that you need to prepare India as a whole from your static general awareness point of view. At least prepare the things regarding India that are there in the news, because in recent SEBI grade A examination we have seen that in there was a question that how many islands are there in Lakshadweep. So one question is there from Lakshadweep in SEBI examination, but in Puducherry's but in RBI's examination you can see the number of assembly seats of Puducherry is being asked. So in this manner you need to broaden your perspective. So you can expect such questions in the coming examination as well of your RBI grade B examination. Now, agriculture and farmer welfare. So you have seen one question in 2018, then there was no question in 2019, but when with the change in the pattern, we can say 3 questions were asked from the agriculture and farmer welfare. So guys, again, this makes it all the more important section, but we can put a lesser importance on this section in comparison to the other section. So you can create a reverse hierarchy here. The topic or the section from where the maximum questions are being asked, put that topic in the first order of the list, and then you can make the list in the decreasing order. Then you have defense. 2 questions, and then you can see in 2019, 9 questions were asked, but in 2020 to 2021, only 2 questions were asked. Now, what does this mean? Can we expect no question from the defense segment in your upcoming examination? No. Defense se puche ja sakte hai question. Now, what kind of questions? So, guys, first question was weapons. Like your naval ships that are commissioned by the government or that are bought from other countries. So that question was asked. Second is your exercise, defense exercise. And third type of question from the defense segment is the defense equipment that we have given to another country. That was also a question in your examination. Okay, so pay attention to the equipments that we give to other countries. So these are 3 types of questions that you can cover from your defense segment. Then you can see MOU, say only 1 question was there in 2018. Then you can consistently see there is no question in the years. Now, what does this mean? This means that you can put the MOUs towards the end of your list. Okay, so you can keep MOU section for the last. ये आप इससे इंफ्रेंस निकाल सकते हैं, बट अगेन आई वुड एडवाइज यू डू नॉट इग्नोर द MOUs कम्प्लीटली. वॉट यू कैन डू इज द MOUs दैट हैव बीन साइंड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, प्रिपेयर देम थरली, एंड द MOUs दैट द स्टेट इज साइनिंग विद द अदर कंट्रीज और विद द अदर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दोज MOUs यू कैन स्किप इवन फॉर अ सेकेंड, बट डू नॉट थिंक ऑफ स्किपिंग द एंटायर मेमोरेंडम ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग section of your Spotlight magazine, because you can never know what is there in the examiner's mind, right? Next is your international. Now guys, one very peculiar thing I observed when I did the past year analysis, that was that this section has become more and more difficult. In 2018 you had very easy questions like where was the G7 summit held, or where is the G7 summit of 2022 going to be held. But in 2019, you can see there are more questions, and in 2020 to 2021, there are again more questions from the international segment, but the level of questions has become more and more difficult. So here you need to prepare the international section from the Spotlight magazine thoroughly. Do not skip this section, because this has now hold more and more significance. Now, and you have Russia-Ukraine crisis, you have de-dollarization coming up, and all of these things make this section more and more important. The next section that we have is reports and indices. Now here you can see one question is there in 2018, and over the years the number has increased. Now guys, what kind of indices are being asked? Every kind of report. Okay, be it your innovation index, be it your climate change risk index, be it your any report, Forbes richest women list, okay, such kind of reports and indices taken together have been asked in the examinations in the past years. Okay, so reports and indices ka section bhi aapko bahut acche se prepare karna hai, and remember that this section does not hold relevance for your phase 1 only. Phase 2 mein bhi isse questions aate hain in your ESI paper, so this section need not to be neglected by you all. Now guys, next we have banking and economy, the very 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 important section. You can clearly see the number of questions. Acha, one more thing that should be there in your mind right now, or I think that must be popping in your minds, itne sare questions. So let me tell you guys that this is the analysis of both the shifts, morning and evening shift, okay, both shifts. The cumulative analysis of both the shifts give you the clear picture, okay, of each and every section. Therefore I have combined the number of questions that were asked in each and every shift of each year. Okay, so here you can see 24 questions were asked in 2018 from the banking and economy, then 31 questions were there in 2019 in both the shifts together, okay, in morning shift and evening shift ke dono ke questions ko milakar total 31 questions were from the banking and economy section. Then in 2020 to 2021, total 53 questions were there in morning and evening, okay, dono ko mila karke total 53 questions hai jo banking and economy se aaye hain aapke. Now what kind of questions? So what I observed in 2020 to 2021's pattern, first thing is that individual companies or private company ke questions bahut aaye hain. So this is one thing that you should not skip. Now which company is important? Aise to bahut sari companies aati hain, and if you pick up mint paper, then it is the completely the business newspaper. You have many news of business, so how will you identify it? In my perspective, don't identify it, don't waste your time in identifying the companies, because I am doing that for you in the Spotlight magazine. So what you have to do is you have to just prepare thoroughly the banking and economy section. Now the next point is the budget. I have put the budget questions also in this banking and economy section only. Then I also observed a question of disinvestment target. Okay, so budget to aapka bataiye bahut hi zyada important, it's ultimate thing that you cannot skip. So बजट करना है आपको, इंडिविजुअल कंपनी से रिलेटेड जो क्वेश्चन है वो तो आपके पूछे ही जाते हैं, दैट इज कवर्ड इन स्पॉटलाइट. नेक्स्ट थिंग दैट इज आस्क्ड इज द रेगुलेशंस और द गाइडलाइंस रिलीज्ड बाय आरबीआई और द रेगुलेटर्स. नेक्स्ट कमिटीज फॉर्म्ड बाय आरबीआई और देयर पर्पसेस और देयर चेयर. ठीक है, तो ये सारी चीजें कुछ हैं जो आपकी बैंकिंग एंड इकोनॉमी सेक्शन से पूछी जा रही हैं, और it is expected that they will also be asked in the upcoming examination. So prepare them thoroughly. You don't have to worry about exactly what you have to cover, because that is prepared in the spotlight. Okay, so usse aap prepare kar sakte hain, but budget and economic survey we have already given you separately, so you can watch our video, you can get the PDF and prepare from there. So guys, I'm again saying banking and economy is a huge section. You can clearly see the number of questions coming from this section. Next is the GDP, and unfortunately we don't have any question. or rather I should say fortunately we don't have any question from the GDP. But does that mean you can skip it? In my opinion, keep GDP and MOU for the last. Okay, last में एक बार नज़र डाल लेना कि किसने क्या GDP दिया है, because it can be asked. क्योंकि RBI के ESI paper में one question was there that what is the reason for which IMF has reduced India's GDP forecast. That was a question. Okay, so that was coming up from GDP forecast only. So for the last, you can keep your GDP forecast. And one more thing, that the GDP is provided by the very important organizations like World Bank, Asian Development Bank, IMF, OECD, Moody's, India's, NSO, RBI. ये कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है, इनके जीडीपी कर लेना अच्छे से. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस स्टैनली और स्टैनली मॉर्गन है, गोल्डमैन सैक्स है, अगर इनका नहीं भी कर पा रहे हो तो भी इट्स ओके, बिकॉज आप जानते ही हो कि क्वेश्चंस नहीं पूछे जा रहे हैं जीडीपी में से. बट टू बी ऑन अ सेफर साइड, डू नॉट इग्नोर देयर जीडीपीज. ओके, नेक्स्ट इज अपॉइंटमेंट. वन क्वेश्चन फाइव. सो क्लियरली अपॉइंटमेंट्स हैज गेन्ड मोमेंटम ओवर द इयर्स. फाइव क्वेश्चंस वर आस्क्ड फ्रॉम अपॉइंटमेंट सेक्शन. Now there is one more thing that is to be discussed here, and that is that questions tricky banaye ja rahe hain. For example, there was a question, or I should say there was a news about the president of Seychelles being appointed. But what was the question that was asked in your examination? That where is Seychelles located? Okay, so news to appointment hi hai, but question aapse aur bhi in depth pucha ja raha hai. To is hisab se aapko strategically प्रिपेयर करना है एंड कवर ऑल दी डायनेमिक्स ऑफ द न्यूज़ एट द सेम टाइम. एटलीस्ट द स्टैटिक फैक्ट्स रिलेटेड टू द कंट्री, रिलेटेड टू द न्यूज़. नेक्स्ट वी हैव इम्पॉर्टेंट डेज. देन टू क्वेश्चंस वर देयर, बट देन वी सी सेवन क्वेश्चंस इन 2019 एंड फाइव क्वेश्चंस इन 2020 टू 2021. सो अगेन इम्पॉर्टेंट डेज भी बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है. देन थीम्स पूछी जा रही हैं काफ़ी. ओके, सो मेजरली द क्वेश्चंस आर ऑन themes only. Then you have awards. So here in 2019 you saw 13 questions directly from the awards, and one of the most important awards that has been continuously asked by the RBI is Nobel Prize. So Nobel ko acche se karna hai, kisko mila hai, kis liye mila hai, aur kaun si country se wo banda belong karta hai. Ye sari cheeze hain jo Nobel se related aapko pata honi chahiye. Then you have three questions from the award section in your 2020 to 2021. But do not think that in the last year's examination only three questions were there, therefore award section is not very important. It is important, but yes, as I told you that you can prepare a decreasing order, a list in decreasing order of the sections that are important, so you can just keep awards in a later part of the list. Then you have sports. Eight questions, 16 in 2019 and 7 in 2020 to 2021. So this clearly stating, this is clearly telling you how sports is, how much sports is important. Then books and obituary. Four questions were in 2018, seven questions were in 2019, and only one question was asked from you from the obituary section in your 2020 to 2021. So again, you can keep this section towards the end of your list, because this is again a little bit of, or we can say a less important section, a lesser important section. Then we have static GK. So many students are really confused about the number of questions that are asked from the static GK. But you can clearly see that 21 questions were there from the static GK in 2018, but over the years the significance of this section has reduced. 19 may 18 questions, and then in 2020 to 2021, 10 questions were asked. Now what kind of questions comprise static GK section? First of all, national park, wildlife sanctuary, then the full forms of organization like BIMSTEC. Yes, this was a question in your RBI in 2018. However, I know that this sounds a little bit impossible now because we have seen this examination. But guys, this was a question. BIMSTEC की full form पूछी गई थी, but full form पूछी जा चुकी है वैसे भी. ठीक है, your banking related awareness, so that is also important, like your marginal standing facility की significance क्या है. I guess that was a question in your RBI examination. So banking awareness also comprises your static GK part and your international organization's headquarters. There was one question on International Boxing Association's headquarters. Okay, so headquarters have always been important, so do memorize the headquarters. Then there was one question on the capital of Finland. Okay, so such kind of questions are being asked from you. So static GK ka aap dekh rahe hain kitna importance hai, usko bhi prepare karna hai, par kahan se prepare karna hai? Now that is the question. So guys, static GK ke liye we have provided you with the enough PDFs and also ek session bhi liya ja chuka hai on static GK. You can watch that session. And guys, static GK bhi aapki current se hi uthai ja rahi hai. For example, if a question is there on Tiger Reserve, so you must find that Tiger Reserve in the news itself. कहीं ना कहीं वो न्यूज़ में होगा, तभी उससे क्वेश्चन आपका बना है एग्जाम में. ठीक है, तो आपको कहाँ से प्रिपेयर करना है? फर्स्ट स्पॉटलाइट से पढ़ो, आप जितना भी है कंटेंट पहले स्पॉटलाइट अच्छे से प्रिपेयर करो, देन प्रिपेयर स्टैटिक जीके कवर्ड बाय अस. ओके, सो गाइज, दिस वॉज द ट्रेंड एनालिसिस बाय अस. आई होप दैट इट वॉज हेल्पफुल फॉर यू इन एनालाइजिंग द नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द सेक्शंस, एंड एट द सेम टाइम यू नो, by this time you know that which section is important and what kind of questions are being asked from the sections. Okay, so guys, here let's end this session, but before that I would like to inform you about the application of ours. So guys, this is the app where you can find everything related to your examination. So download this application, and spotlight bhi aapko isi application pe milegi. So download it and prepare. Good luck and have a good day. Prepare hard for the examination. Bye bye.